Hey guys, and welcome to another episode on my channel. Today I'm gonna show you how to create atmospheric art in a blender in 10 minutes. It's easier than you think and it doesn't take much to create realistic art. Just watch this video till the end and you can make such cool pictures today with only a blender. I collected references with atmospheric light and rays in some caves and we can create the same scene in a blender. The first thing that I need is the main mounting object. For that I'm going to use the Blender Kit add-on. Just search for a mountain and here we can see a lot of mountains, rocks and cliffs. Also, that add-on has a lot of high quality Blender models and photo scans as free and paid. I already found and saved a couple of mountains that I think are pretty fit to this art. I just choose this one and drop into my Blender scene. And I have another model, we could try a couple of them and see which is better. Rotate and place it somewhere here. I also want to use some guy on the top of this rock, so I need some place on the mountain to put this guy there. Maybe this cliff would be better for this purpose because it has some flat spaces where I can put the man. Also, I would like to find some more flat mountain surface for the foreground in the Blender Kit. You may find the link to get 10% off on paid subscription on Blender Kit or use it for free, link in the description. Also, if you wanna sell your models, you may become a creator and add your models, which will be easily available for other subscribers in the Blender Kit. Alright, as you have seen this art on my Instagram, I need some kind of cave with top hole where the light passes and reproduces rays. In order to create some kind of cave, I start with circle. Place it somewhere here. It will be the hole for the light. I go to edit mode, press F to make a face and E to extrude geometry. Then delete these two faces, I don't need them, and keep going to create the shape of the cave. Extrude, scale and adjust position while it becomes reminiscent of the cave with a hole on the top. I remove some faces here to see what is happening inside. In the references we can see another masterwork formation in the foreground. We can use the model that I saved in the Blender Kit before. Just rotate it and place some kind of like this. Duplicate it to the other side of the frame and rotate to create an interesting shape of the rock, which creates this depth of image divide foreground and background. Turn on interactive render and make the color black. Turn off all the light in this scene. It's dark and there is where we start. I'm going to use my light assets to make atmospheric light rays. I drop this one to the scene and let's place it somewhere behind the hole that the light falls down inside the cave through it. I increase the light power and I add the volume cube which I already have in my light assets which helps me to make the light rays in one click. Place it here and now we can see the light. Just make this cube visibility like bounce so that he will not disturb me. And let's play with light. I guess we need more power and size. The last one brings the light rays to more natural. If we look at the reference, the light here has a softened shape and border, but in the blender now it's so sharp. I increase the size value to make the light source larger and see how it changed to natural, like on the reference. If I open Shader Editor, I can adjust the mapping of texture light and slightly move the light rays effect to get this effect like I want. Just move it on the X or Y axis. If you need this light asset, find the link in the description where you can make download this asset. I'm delighted at this light and this rays looks fine. But I wanna get rid of this dark area behind the light hole. I guess there must be sky. So add a new plan and place it here, add the new material. Delete principles BSDF. I need emission material with some kind of bluish sky color, like this. Increase the strength and it's enough for now. Let's move ahead and add some trees like on the reference. For this I'm going to use a botanic add-on, choose some kind of this tree, place it here and duplicate it, make variety of them. It would seem like there are a forest. And return to this object. I would like to see here mountain rocks material that I already created for my upcoming environment procedural material collection. I do append and choose my material as tree nodes. This is procedural mounted material which you have seen in my previous video, but I gather it into one useful group node. This is customizable material with different settings like scale, bump, displacement and others. To make it more realistic, I subdivide geometry to use sculpting in the blend to add some details. It also will be necessary because I have displacement settings in this material, and to use the settings properly I need more density of the topology. Okay, it's time to make a hero in our art. I add a plane and I already have this guy. This is a simple photo that I get on FreePic and removed the background in Photoshop. Saved it as a PNG with alpha channel. And now I drop this one into shader editor. Connect to base color and to alpha. We need to scale it in X axis to make it in real size. Rotate it and let's place it somewhere here on the top of the mountain, like in my references. And we can see that in a preview render our guy looks realistic. I just move this plane to some point a little bit behind the rock. And now it looks amazing. Besides, this way is absolutely easy way to use people in your art without using 3D models. It's free because you may use plenty of free photo banks and use any people in your art. Alright, here is my draft render and let's do some post-production and post-effects. I will be using Compositing in a blender for this purpose. Of course, we can do it in a Photoshop, but I'm also going to use a real-time compositor to make final adjustments in this scene. So if I make post-production in compositing, it will be working in real-time compositing in 3D viewport as well. So if we look at the reference one more time, the light rays have some glow effect in the top part and it slightly disappears to the darkness in the bottom side. To create this effect I need a mask. In the image editor I change view to mask and press new mask. Now I can draw a mask and make the shape of the mask looks like the shape of the light. Press Alt S to make this mask soften. Now I can use this mask in compositing. Press Shift A and search mask node. Choose the mask that I've created and we need a hue saturation node. Increasing the value I can do light brighten. And maybe adjust the mask shape. Now I need a new mask to exclude some parts from the first mask because I wanna make the lighter part on the top side and decrease the brightness to the bottom. Just connect my first mask as a factor and the new mask into the second image. For the first image input I use black color. Now you may see how it works. Alright, I need to darken this part of the image and I have created another mask for this. Also another hue saturation node and decrease the value I can make it darken. So this is what it looks like and the next step I wanna do some color gradient in Blender using color balance node. It would be great to make this area dark and to make vignette effect, but only on these tops emphasize this rock shape. Add another mask, adjust size and pull down the bottom side of the mask to make it some kind of like this. Decrease the value in the hue saturation node and that's what I want. Finally, I make a post effects. I already have here glare and I wanna add lens distortion with a small value to make this image more cinematic. So this is what my post-production looks like. I do before and after to see difference. Looks interesting, but I would like to make small details like dust. For this I add a dust smoke image into compositing and using a mix not to combine it with my render. Just need to transform it a little bit and match the color of my main image using color balance. Before and after. It looks cool. I'm going to use the same way to add some dust on the other parts of the image and combine one dust image into one variety dust image using combination of mix node and transform nodes. I add this image of the dust and combine it with my main render using mix node. Change the blending mode to screen and decrease the factor value to make this dust slightly noticeable. The next step, I need the transform node, which allows me to reduce the dust image and move it to the necessary part of my render. Some kind of like this. And I wanna use this image on the opposite side of the render. For that, I do copy the transform node and move this image to the other side. Just change the settings. Now we need to combine this into one image. Mix node and connect it to the main render. Just change mix to add. Thus, having one image, I can use it many times simply by duplicating the transform node and merging it with the main render. Alright, there are two realistic renders that I made in a blender. In my Instagram we couldn't decide which is the best, so write in the comments which you like more. Also consider to subscribe if you're not subscribed yet, smash the like and share this video with your friends. Subscribe to my Patreon if you need to download blender scenes, assets and get other stuff. Create amazing art and see you in the next one.